Hey guys, it's Rebecca. Today I'm gonna talk about my top 10 favorite standalones for now. Because later when I read even more books, there will be inclusions as well as exclusions from this list. Also keep a note that this list of mine is not in any particular order. Now let's move on with the video. The first book that I'm gonna talk to you guys about is Ben-Hur by Lou Wallace. This book is a Christian classic and it is about a man named Judah Ben-Hur who faces betrayal from his childhood friend, that is Messala, and also he is wrongly accused of attempting to murder the Roman governor. Hence he is sentenced to be a slave and he is sent to the galley ships. He vows to take revenge against the Romans as well as his childhood friend Messala. In this book, it is portrayed that Jesus and Ben-Hur was existing in the same period of time. So eventually they meet each other in the course of time. And this book is about how his thoughts and mindset changed after seeing and meeting Jesus on taking revenge. And I think even though people call this a Christian classic, I think everyone should read it. It's an amazing book. The second book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Book Thief by Marcus Zusak. God, this book just thoroughly blew my mind off. It's such an amazing book. I thoroughly loved it. It's so nice. Okay, so the story takes place in the Nazi Germany during the Second World War. And it's about a girl named Liesel Memminger who lives with her foster parents and who loves to read books. She reads books by stealing them. So this whole book is about her life and how it changed when her parents and she decided to give refuge to a Jew. This is such a wonderful book. I just love the concept. I love the setting. And I also love the idea of the author to personify death. It's so nice. This book is narrated by death. Can you imagine that? That's so nice. And I highly, highly recommend this book to everyone. And I still can't believe there are people who haven't read this book. This is such a nice book. The third book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is Pride and Prejudice by Jane Austen. This book is a romantic classic novel. And this book features the love story between Mr. Fitzwilliam Darcy and Miss Elizabeth Bennet. The main theme of this book is marriage and love. And in this book, The Pride and Prejudice, the word pride is used to refer to Mr. Fitzwilliam Darcy and the word prejudice is used to refer to Miss Elizabeth Bennet. And I think it's really a fun time to go through this book. It's really fun to read through it. The fourth book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is 21 Days by J.C. Gatlin. I just love this book. It's so nice book. So this book is about a girl named Abigail Reed who turns 21 years old and her friends host a party for her and they play a game of 21 Days. This game is in a manner that each time a dare will appear in Abigail's phone in the text messages and she has to accomplish the task or the dare and send back a text message saying dare accomplished, and so the next dare comes up. So after finishing the 21 days, she'll be able to meet the surprising person who's sending the 21 dares. In the beginning it starts with happy dares, funny dares, but later the dares turns deadly and life-taking. So it's now up to Abigail to find out the anonymous person who's behind the screen. This book is such a breathtaking book. I finished this book in just 2 sittings. I couldn't wait any longer. The fifth book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Story of My Life by Helen Keller. So this book is an autobiography of Helen Keller. It talks to you about the difficulties faced by Helen Keller in her life and how she conquered her inabilities, her disabilities, and made it into her strength. This book inspires you a lot and it helps you to be thankful to God for making you an able person also. It's such a nice book and I think you guys should read it. The sixth book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Mystery of Alice by Lee Bacon. So this is an audiobook, and this was the first audiobook that I had heard in Audible. In this book, there's a girl named Emily Pau who decides to write a scholarship exam to get into an elite school known as Auden School. So the scholarship exam is very unique, and it's not like the other scholarship exams. In this scholarship exam, the candidate is put in a room and he or she is expected to find clues and open the lock of the door and get out. So whoever does this and accomplishes the task is given the scholarship. And only Alice, another girl, Alice and Emily was able to accomplish this task. And they go to Auden School. But later, Emily finds this girl named Alice very mysterious, and now it is up to her to find all the secrets behind Alice. Well, I loved this book, but the ending was not much satisfactory, but then I really loved this book. The seventh book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Remains of the Day by Kazuo Ishiguro. I hope I'm pronouncing the author's name rightly. Okay. So this book is about a man named Stevens, who is the butler of the Darlington Hall, who goes for a jolly ride for 1 week, and he recalls all his past during this ride. And it's so nice to read through it, and it gives you such a soothing feel, and it's really nice. And the eighth book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is To Kill a Mockingbird by Harper Lee. So this book is narrated by a girl who's 8 years old, named Scout. Atticus, the father of Scout, and her brother Jem is a lawyer and decides to fight in the court for a black man named Tom Robinson, who's wrongly accused of raping a white woman. And even though Atticus provides enough proofs and documents to prove that Tom Robinson is not guilty, still Tom Robinson is sentenced to imprisonment. And seeing this, Jem and Scout's belief on judicial system completely goes away. I think even though this book was written years ago, it's quite relevant even today. And I think people should read it and mend their ways. The ninth book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Palace of Illusions by Chitra Banerjee Devakaruni. So this book is the retelling of Mahabharata from the point of view of Panchali or Draupadi. I personally love epics and mythology, so I completely loved this book. I found this book so interesting. Normally all the epics are written from the point of view of men, but this book, The Palace of Illusions, through this book we could see Mahabharata from a female point of view, and I really loved it. And I think people who love mythology and epics should take up this book. The final book that I'm going to talk to you guys about is The Three Men in a Boat by Jerome K. Jerome. So this book is about the author and his two friends going on a boating trip. I got this book as a novel to study in my 9th grade, and I was quite hesitant to read this book. But then when I started reading, I loved it. It's such a hilarious book, and if you want to have a hearty laugh reading a book, you should definitely pick this one. It's so nice and amazing book. So those were the top 10 favorite standalones of mine for now. Let me know about your favorite standalones in the comments below, and recommend me few standalones that I should be reading. Thank you guys for watching my video. I'll see you guys in my next video.